to tell. Ooh, closer. They whisper in your ear. Say the words you long to hear. I'm in love with you. Ooh, need to tell. Oh, closer. They whisper in your ear. Say the words you want to hear. I'm in love with you. Oh, I've known a secret for a week or two. Nobody knows, just we do. Your ear, say the words you long to hear. I'm in love with you. Oh, 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 oh,
well, howdy there, pluckers. I was soaring to the end with hopefully another interesting lesson for you. A classic old Beatles song called Do You Want to Know a Secret, of course. Originally written and performed by them, and then a year or so later it was covered by Billy J. Kramer and the Dakotas, and it became a very big hit in the UK and Europe, I think. Okay, so this is the standard, the original Beatles version I'm doing a lesson on, obviously. Standard tuning, no capos. Same key as the original Beatles record, okay? So let's do the intro then, off we go. So starting off with an E minor, okay? This sort of intro, E minor, and then some very light strumming on the top strings, on the thin strings. I tend to do it near the bridge somewhere. Because if you do it down here, your pick tends to get stuck in the strings, I find. Just very lightly. Top two or three strings, yeah? So. You never know how I'm going to try. Then we go to an A minor strum and some more high. More strumming. Okay, so it's. You never know how much I really. Back to E minor, love you. G. You'll never know how much I F really. And then a B, or a B6 actually. Okay, so that's a G chord. You'll never know how much I really care. Now, you can play a G chord, you don't know, whichever G you want, okay? I'm playing a bar chord. You could play a three-finger G or a four-finger G, whichever you want, okay? As long as it's a G chord. You can then an F, I'm playing an F bar chord, but you could play a simple F or a four-fingered F, as long as it's an F, okay? So from the beginning, you'll never know how much I love. You'll never know how much I really care. Right, this is a B6th, okay. What I'm doing, I'm playing a B bar chord. I'm only actually barring the first five strings with the first finger myself, but you can do all six, it's up to you. And then I'm doing the usual bar with the first three with the finger, but instead of just doing those three, the fourth string, the third string, and the second string, I'm actually barring the first four strings. So I'm actually doing the fourth fret of the top E string as well. And then all you do is arpeggiate down. Okay, that's it. And if you listen to the actual original record, you'll hear that there's obviously two of them playing it. And one of them stops on the B. and then the other one carries on and does the on the end. Okay, so that's an amalgamation of both guitars. Okay, so let's do it again. You'll never know how much I really, you'll never know how much I really care. Okay, then we come up with this little riff. It's quite simple, but it's quite fiddly to start if you're not used to playing it. It starts off on the second. I would suggest you might use your third finger or second finger, whichever's up to you. Playing the second fret of the A string, okay? You hit that note and you slide it up to the fourth fret on the A string, the fifth string, right? So it's... Right? So you hit it first and then hit it again. And then come back and hit... So, and then come back and hit that second on the fifth again. So it's... Right? Got that? So hit it, then hit it again and slide up very quickly to the fourth fret, and then straight back again and hit that note again on the second fret. Okay? And then you hit the open fourth string, then back to the fifth string on the second fret. Then put your first finger on the first fret of the fourth string and back to the second on the fifth, sorry. So you end up on that second on the fifth, okay? So, got that? So second on the fifth, hit, then hit it again, slide up to the fourth fret, back straight back down again to the second fret and hit that again on the fifth string. Then the open fourth, second on the fifth, first on the fourth, second on the fifth. So, okay, and then you're into an E chord, first chord of the verse, okay? The verse itself starts off with the E. Listen. Right, that's a G sharp minor, to a G minor, to an F sharp minor. Same chord shape all the way from the 4th fret, 3rd fret, bar, 2nd fret. You don't have to use the bar, you can do it simply by barring the first 3 strings with your first finger. And then on the 4th fret, and then the 6th fret of the 5th string and the 4th string. And then take it down 1 fret, and then take it down again to the F sharp minor on the 2nd fret. Okay? So it's listen. To play it, okay, bar chord or otherwise. Now it's quite, it's got a definite strum pattern to this. You can just do that, but on the record, to actually sound more like the record, it's down, up, down, up, down, up, okay, right? Okay, so it's down, up, down, up, down, really. Okay, so from the beginning, let's go right to the very slowly. You'll never know how much I really care. You'll never know how much I really care. Listen, do you want to know a secret? Right, so. Let's go through this again. E, listen, then you do the 3 chord rundown. G sharp minor, G minor, F sharp minor. Do you B again? I have 3 fingers. This time it's a B. A lot of people play B7. You can play B7 there if you want to instead of the B. So listen. Do you want to? See, I don't personally like that. It's up to you. I think it's a B myself. I've stand corrected, but my ears like the E better than the B rather than the B7. But listen, do you want to know a secret? It just repeats. Do you want to know? Right, got that. So let's do it again. So listen, F sharp minor, B. B again. Listen. Do you promise not to tell? Oh, oh, F, O, oh, E. Okay? I I have seen people play an A minor there instead of the F. I think it's an F. But if you prefer an A minor, try an A minor. I think it's an F. But it's my ears. It might be different to everyone else's, okay? But there's an option there. You could play an A minor. You can get away with an A minor. But I think it's an F, okay? So I'll show you the A minor. Listen. Listen, do you want to know a secret? Do you promise not to tell? Oh, I don't like that myself, but I've seen other people play it like that. I think it's an F, okay? So I'm going to stick with the F, okay? So that's it, and basically it just repeats that whole thing for the second verse, and then it goes into the bridge section. Okay, so from the beginning, first verse, listen. Do you want to know a secret? Do you promise not to tell? F, E, also repeat. Let me whisper in your ear. Say the words you long to. Now, second on the second verse, you go to an A. Here, to the B, here, I'm in love with C sharp minor, you, 4-fret bar chord minor shape. Okay, so the second verse, closer, let me whisper in your ear, say the words you long to, A, here, B, here, I'm in love, C sharp minor, you. And then what we do is what I'm doing anyway. So I just pick, you strum the chord here, where it goes, I'm in love with you. I just go from the C sharp minor, I strum it once here, and then I pick 5, 4, 3, 2, then possibly 3, and then do an F sharp minor. And then a B. So the whole second verse, closer. Sorry, closer. Let me whisper in your ear. Say the words you long to hear. I'm in love with you. Whoa. And it goes into the next verse, and it's like for the first verse again, and then the second verse again, as far as the chord sequence is concerned, okay? It just basically repeats the whole thing that you've already done, okay? So we'll go all the way to up to that point, okay? So right from the beginning, okay? You'll never know how much I for a week or two, that bit, okay? I've known a secret for a week or two, right? So it's after you come out of that, I'm in love with you, where it goes, here, say the words, here, I'm in love with you, down to the A again, I've known a secret for a week or two, That's A to F sharp minor to C sharp minor to B minor. Second, this is the first new one we've got. This is the second fret bar chord minor shape. Okay, so A, F sharp minor, C sharp minor, B minor. So it's I've known a secret for a week or two. Repeat A. Or the F sharp minor is for a C sharp minor. B minor two, F sharp minor, and I'm doing a rundown. You could play a B chord there after the F sharp minor, but during that, I prefer to play the rundown if I'm playing by myself, obviously. Okay, so this whole bit again, A, C, F sharp minor, C sharp minor, B minor, A. F sharp minor, C sharp minor, B minor, F sharp minor, run down on B. That's 2nd fret 5th string, open 5th string, 4th fret of the bottom E string, 2nd fret bottom E string, and then you're into the next verse again, E chord. Okay, so I'll do the second, the last verse before the middle section, okay? So, closer, let me whisper in your ear, say the words you long to hear, I'm in love with you, whoa, whoa, whoa. I've known a secret for a week or two, just we two. And then there's a couple of verses again. Listen, do you want to know a secret? Do you promise not to tell? Oh, oh, oh. Closer, let me whisper in your ear. Words you long to hear, I'm in love with you, oh, 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 oh. Typical Beatles ending, but obviously their song doesn't actually end, it fades out. Hence my ending. Okay, so all you do on that second verse bit, close the closer bit, the last bit you of the song, closer, let me whisper in your ear, say the words you long to hear, yeah, I'm in love with you, whoa, 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 and they just repeat the C sharp minor bit. Whoa, you just strum the chord. Whoa, 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 whoa. And then after the third time, you play an E6. E chord with the pinky on the second fret of the second string, the B string. Typical Beatles ending chord. Okay? So there you have it, boys and girls. So just go through this ending one again. Closer. In your ear, say the words you long to hear, say in love with you, whoa, 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 whoa. Thanks very much for watching and listening to that, and hopefully you'll enjoy that and have a go at it. Thanks very much for being sticking in it, and we'll see you in the next lesson for another classic. Bye for now.